We may curse heaven for our fate, but hell is a device of our own construction. The Ebony Tower, number one on the New York Times bestsellers list, 5 weeks running. We are the architects of our own destiny. There's no instance, only ignorance. Nobody could ever accuse me of empathy, of genuinely caring for people.
This is
true. They'd probably say that Sam Krieg is a cold son of a bitch.
Also true.
And they'd be right. People don't interest me. The acts of people. Now those are intrinsically interesting. Particularly the consequences of those actions.
Yeah.
Cause and effect. Crime and punishment. It's every
Can
book
he
I ever
see
wrote
my
and
soul?
Sold a million copies of. So what did the good
or is it
folk
just
of
that
Kingsman
weird author
do
insight?
Fate? I tell you.
Could be
they
both.
Were evil. Kingsmith Solomon County, pure evil, all of it. Like a modern day Sodom and Gomorrah.
Well, come
Always
on, some of them
was.
Are okay.
From the moment the pilgrim stepped off the boat and set forth on these shores.
And he's a nice guy.
A dark rock.
Madame Roger's good.
Veil of the Labor Day barbecues, homecoming parades, and maple syrup. I should know. The deeper I dug, the darker the hole, the more I found.
Helen, she's cool.
A goddamn abyss of foreshadowing.
Norma.
I'm not so sure about her. There's something off about her.
Right out there, that people might confuse him for one.
I mean, I guess, but I mean, everyone in the town's a little off.
And I'm sure you have.
That's true.
You'd know that this place has blood on its hands and plenty of crime to its name. I'm sure you know this one. Show a gun on the mantelpiece in the first act. Before the curtain goes down, it's going to blow someone's scrotum off.
Ew.
Upon the wicked.
I don't think that's how it goes.
Of fire and brimstone. The day the fog rolled in, I stood up here in this ivory tower and watched it all. It came like an avalanche, like a tsunami, obscuring everything in its path. First the shoreline, then the fields, the forest, the town. It lingered for a while before receding. There was no one left. The fog took them, all of them. At least that's what I thought at first glance. Turned out there were others who escaped the fog somehow. Me and the sheriff, she was paying a friendly visit. I was above it all. It didn't touch us. That night, it was deathly quiet. The fog around the island obscured everything, sight and sound. One or two people tried to leave. They walked into that thick mist, and all we heard were the screams. The next morning, with the dawn, came the townsfolk, returning from the sea. Like one of my stories. Followed by what the Wabanaki once called the Pale Men. The Draug. That's when I decided to stay put and keep writing. There's a strange inspiration to be found in imprisonment.
I kind of get that, too.
Yep.
I mean, if I leave... Apparently I'm okay with going to London, but if I leave a certain... That's one little district in New York, my neck starts beeping.
Yeah, that's... You don't want to push the beeping. Are you shitting me, Lucinda? Good for public relations? I think you get off on connecting me with these lunatic fans. I think you're hoping I'll kill someone. Wouldn't it be wonderful to bump sails and get rid of me in a most spectacular fashion? This fanatic you found is even more obsessed than the redhead in Tulsa. You ever been to Tulsa, Debbie?
No.
Okay. Sure, I got information out of him, but it took everything I had not to blow his balls off. And I bet I could have got away with it too, Your Honor. Look at the website that man has about me. Look at this picture I had to throw in the garbage. Notice the pathetic eyes begging me to end his miserable life. I would also like to submit into evidence this goddamn fucking town. I had to abandon my car at an intersection because the gravel road, with the stupidest sentimental name I have ever heard, became too narrow. Oh, and thank you for the GPS, Lucinda. It tried its utmost to steer me into a fiery fucking death.
You know, you're just like one of my characters. You love evil. You don't run from it. You don't try to avoid it. You welcome it. You crave it. You invite the pain and you cherish the suffering. You dive right into the filth and you make no attempt to wash it off.
I wash it off at least.
Step back out, it doesn't matter how bad it smells, how the stench and the taint cling to you.
Ew.
You just can't wait to dive back in. Like a dope fiend hankering for a fix, you don't want it to ever end. You need it. Your entire identity, your raison d'etre, is at stake. Think about it. Who would you be? What would you be without this?
I wouldn't be anybody.
Without your precious war on evil.
I wasn't.
Without your secret world, your sacred brotherhoods, your ranks and titles and rituals. You'd be just another rat stuck in the race with a dead-end job, living for a paycheck and the weekends. One long booze-soaked downhill slide towards the dark and cold grave.
Damn it.
But you probably believe in what you do. Believe it's right. That it's good. You soak in it so others don't have to. You take one for the team.
I always have.
You bend over and spread your legs and let the darkness
Sam.
And somehow you justify it all with utilitarian pragmatism. You're a bona fide American hero. Get the hell out of here. Go find an abyss to jump into. Go soak yourself in filth. Maybe it'll be different this time. Maybe you'll save them all. Maybe you'll finally find some goddamn peace. Some closure. You're just like every single character I've ever written. Fucked from page one.
I don't feel good.
He's just trying to get to you, Debbie.
Well, it's working. Jonah felt an acute and intense sense of dread slowly overcome him as he watched the savage coast beneath. Savage coast? In the monotonous shadows of the cold, flickering light from the old lighthouse, he could see them coming from the sea, slimy and ancient beings of the most terrible nightmares, waking from their cold graves in the deep and slowly walking to the shore. The time has finally come, and Jonah started to laugh hysterically to himself, fear and wonder, he thought, fascination or plain insanity. Then he ran out to greet his inevitable destiny.
Okay, this is very on the nose.
You know, he's an asshole, but he's not wrong.
Well, not wrong isn't the same as right.
I mean, I do kind of... I mean, I think that my experience in the park just proves that I do crave it. I like the violence. I enjoy all the killing, Snake.
I don't know how to end that line.
I know, it's... undercuts the seriousness when I reference pop culture, but you know what? I can't help myself sometimes.
Well,
I don't know if I was always this way, though. I wonder what can change your nature. Can bad experiences?
What can change the nature of a man?
You know, there was a time I answered love for that, but that's not true. Now I might answer, what were the options?
There were a lot of options.
Was trauma one?
I'm sure it was.
I think that can change your nature.
I think anything can change your nature.
I wonder if anything change your destiny?
You know, personally, I've never really believed in destiny.
Well, the book said that, you know, the character in there just went out to meet his fate with the slimy monsters below. You know what?
fate and destiny are two different things.
Yeah.
You know?
Find your fate, but you meet your fate, but you find your destiny.
Something like that, yeah.
So I guess destiny is better. Anyway. Whatever it is, I'm going there. Oh, that's so much fun.
That was. It looked fun. I wish I could do that without dying.
Yeah, it'd be really... Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So. Now look, the slimy creatures. So, wait, when did he write that book? Do you know when he wrote that book?
I do not. What book was it from? The Lighthouse?
Yeah.
Let's see, I think I still got that blog up.
He also mentioned that guy. Is that the same guy?
You know, it might be. I mean, there's... You know, I mean, for as popular a writer as he is, there aren't a lot of blogs about him. All I found was this one thing on, like, WordPress, of all places.
Isn't that owned by the Russians now?
No, that's LiveJournal.
Okay. Should they own WordPress, too?
Good. Yeah, I'll check. I mean, what isn't owned by the Russians these days? Pointed paws. No, we're automatic is based in San Francisco.
Okay. But that doesn't answer my question.
Oh yeah, right. Let me see here. Where is the Oh my god, The Lighthouse was written in 1987.
Wait, 1987?
1987. AD. If that matters.
I mean, like, that's... What? Does it say what month it was published?
No.
Okay, because... Oh, look, the zombies don't get along with... The big zombies don't get along with the drog, and... It seems like in most of these fights, the drog lose.
Yeah, it's a very clear sorting algorithm. We got the zombies, and then the drog, and then Satan!
Well, the drog kind of... Well, the big zombies, though, beat the drog.
Really? I thought the drog beat the
No. The big drog command the regular zombies, but the big zombies kind of break free, along with the cultist zombies. Actually, I haven't seen the cultist zombies fight them yet. That'd be interesting.
Gotta set up a grudge match.
Svel Queen. I feel like I should do something about that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, is she... Where'd she go? I didn't just do it. Oh. Huh. I guess someone else killed her.
Oh, that sucks. You should have called dibs.
Oh, well. Huh. Wait a minute. That's not a Sam Krieg novel, is it?
You just noticed that among all the debris and the box of human skulls?
Oh! How did I not notice that? Jesus.
The bees.
What the fuck?
What's... Some of that does not look like bones.
I don't know.
Pretty sure there's, like, part of an anchor in there.
Whoa.
What?
You see that?
I can make out, like, a splotch.
Okay, oh, wait, wrong angle. There.
Okay, I can make up a upside-down splotch. Oh, look wait closer. A second. That's on your weapons, isn't it?
Yeah. What the fuck? Did he salvage these? Are they... Like... Okay, what is a Sam Krieg book doing in the Bloody Bones?
Well, he's very popular. He sells a lot of books.
I have so many questions. Yeah, there's another crate. That's crazy. Weird. Okay, what book is... Let's see what book... That'll at least help me date this, because... Undead.
Undead.
I just flipped to a random page, and Allison just ran, refusing to look back. It was like one of those dreams she used to have as a child, where she was being chased. She would run and run, but the harder she ran, the slower she was going, until the beast would catch up and she would wake up screaming in a cold sweat. She could hear them now, catching up with her as she approached the cliffs. She stopped, heaving for breath, and finally turned around. There they were, and this was no dream. The dead had arisen from their graves, and now they were out for blood. Allison was all alone. It was do or die. If she could only reach the old junkyard, she might be able to find a car and get out of there. Your odds of finding a working one are rather slim.
I mean, but, you know, Scrapyard Edgar is a whiz with them bitty titties.
I have no answer for that.
Yeah, that's Scrapyard Edgar for you.
Huh, Undead. The Unrequited, I remember this thing. You know, when was Undead published?
Oh, Undead published 1991.
Okay, so we're moving forward in time, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if there's like a small junkyard near here somewhere. So I figure she was not going to run all the way to Scrapyard Edgar's. And I know this is a book different, like, from... You know what? I have no idea.
I mean, we have... I don't even know if there is a fourth wall anymore.
That is weird.
Probably best not to ask too many questions about our own metafictional existence. I mean, did you ever see Stranger Than Fiction?
No, I heard about it. Spoil it for me.
It was pretty good. You know, like... I mean, the trailers are right. You know, Will Ferrell, you know, he hears the narration of his own life. So he goes to track down the author and, like, find out, you know, like, convince her not to kill him at the end of his book, at the end of the book, because, like, that's what she does with all her protagonists.
So, spoil me. What happens at the end?
She gives him, like, you know, she gives him, like, his rough draft, because apparently it only works when she types out the finished draft. And, like, Will Ferrell, you know, he reads it, and he's like, you know what? This is a good book. I think you should kill me. It's worth it.
That must have been a damn good book.
I know, right?
Oh, look, abandoned junkyard.
This seems oddly convenient. Is this like Scrapyard Edgar's summer home?
I don't know. This is a barn over there.
Yeah.
I don't know. This is just... wait, we're in redneck country. Yeah. You find one of these everywhere.
If you got 5 wrecked cars and a scrapped golem made of the parts on your front lawn, you might be a redneck.
George glanced over at Eliza and contemplated his misfortune. Would the world ever give him a break? No, you're in a Sam Craig novel.
Ha! Fucked from page one.
He shook his head and felt like crying. Just like him to run out of gas in the middle of nowhere, just like her to not be amused. He stepped out of the car and looked around, hoping to find a miracle. It was getting dark and cold wind was sweeping through the damp forest. A loud click. Were they not alone? Other cars around them, rusty and broken down. A graveyard of cars. A loud click. An engine coughing to start. A light from the old barn. He spun around as Eliza screamed. The barn, he thought. They had to make it to the barn. Wonder if she'd go to the barn.
You know, I think I saw the movie version of this once. It had, like, the Green Goblin on a truck.
It's a lot more... That thing was a lot more impressive in the book.
Yeah. You know, Sam Cree actually directed that one? When really? He was high off his balls?
It does not surprise me.
I mean, like, he was at the peak.
What year?
Geez, what one was that? That was the...
Resident Horror.
That was 2000.
Hmm. Whoa! Oh, God.
Jesus.
But wait, it's not hung by its neck.
Oh.
It's hung by its... Oh, my God, it's one of those... you can't see it. It's one of those cultist corpses.
Oh, God, is the rope going through the hole?
Yes.
Oh, God. Ooh.
Is that what the hole is for?
Oh, God. I'm learning more than I wanted to know.
There's other corpses here.
Yeah. Let's...
And it's holding a book.
Of course it is.
Marked. In the shadow of the sparkling flame inside the old barn, he started the ritual. The virgin blood, the ancient symbol. He started reciting the sacred text, careful to keep his rhythm even and his voice firm. Towards the end, he let his voice rise to a crescendo, closed his eyes, and tilted his head back. Arms raised towards the realm of the old gods. Exhausted, he sank to his knees. Finally, to keep his promise. I don't know, that just really hit home. It didn't hit into the... till the end. Oh, I recognize this from the hell alphabet.
I don't remember what letter that was.
They hold a special place among the restless dead. Not just crudely revivified clay, but the animate fragments of an evil life. Devious and clever. The self-aware plague. The pestilent agency. Terror and pain are their food. We speak of the murder of one. We speak of the revenants.
What do revenants have to do with these scarecrows attacking me?
That's a good question.
You think that old man Henderson became a revenant?
I mean, he could be. He sounds like the kind of, you know, crusty old bastard who'd do that.
What if... You think... An evil man dies steeped in black magic.
Mm-hmm.
How did he die?
That's a good question.
And I think... Remember, there was that house. They mentioned the house on the bluff. But, you know... I think I mentioned that before, what I did.
Yeah.
I was so filled with anger and hate that I did the ritual, just cobbled together, and I just screamed to the void for just something to happen. And I didn't think it would answer, but it did.
Did you expect anything to happen at all? Or, you know...
I don't know. I expected to just feel like an idiot. But I figured maybe I'd be like, maybe I could get out of my system or something. Hidden world, draft. When all dreams have been dreamed and all the whispers whispered, you're left with nothing but one thing. Everything is true. The living dead stalk the night and the flames of hell burn bright. There is no dream. And the voices are not in your head. Only the chosen ones can deliver the world from this evil. Oh, okay, what just happened?
Oh, God, what
only
is that?
The children of the bees have the power to clean up the filth and light the torch that illuminate this hidden world.
Okay, wow, that's oddly prescient, and...
I'm still in a draft stage.
Christ, what...
Hello, spoilers. I hadn't read some of these. I was waiting for the movies. But you don't need to be a psychic to know how a Krieg book turns out. We keep an eye on him. He's been buzzing around the occult perimeter for years.
But yeah. Buzzing, lol.
I say he has. I mean, his replaceable starry-eyed nubile assistants. Innocence lost. Everyone goes away with a dark secret. The man practices what he preaches.
Oh, God.
The prediction thing, though, right... Don't be rattled. He got a roadmap for you, too, and it goes, weeks into the future. It's open to sudden shock endings.
Wait, what? I mean... not even worth pretending like I actually know what's going on around here.